द बार मैग्नेट। ग्रेट साइंटिस्ट एल्बर्ट आइंस्टीन, ही गॉट अ मैग्नेट एज अ गिफ्ट व्हेन ही वाज अ चाइल्ड, सो ही वाज क्वाइट फैसिनेटेड बाय इट एंड ही यूज्ड टू प्ले विद इट। सो व्हेन द मैग्नेट अट्रैक्टेड आयरन नेल्स और पिंस, ही वंडर्ड हाउ द मैग्नेट कुड अट्रैक्ट थिंग्स विदाउट टचिंग देम। हाउ इज दिस पॉसिबल? सो दिस फिगर, इफ यू सी, इट शोज द अरेंजमेंट ऑफ दिस आयरन फिलिंग्स स्प्रिंकल्ड ऑन अ प्लेन पेपर which is kept on a bar magnet. So when the paper is tapped twice or thrice, the iron fillings rearrange in a systematic pattern. See, this is a proper pattern. It's a pattern. And similar picture of magnetic field, this can be formed if a bar magnet is replaced by a short solenoid through which the DC current would pass. This is a bar magnet. We are discussing about same for the solenoid, and this is an electric dipole. So these are the magnetic and electric lines. If you see how they are formed because of a bar magnet and a solenoid and a electric dipole. So this figure shows, as I said, magnetic field lines due to the bar magnet and the short solenoid. So electric field lines due to an electric dipole, this also are also shown here for the comparison, because both the lines they have different way of formation, and from this certain conclusions can be made. The magnetic field lines of a magnet, this or a solenoid, they form continuous closed loop. If you see, they form a proper continuous closed loop. The magnetic field lines emerge out from the magnetic north, reach the magnetic south pole, and then again pass through the magnet and reach the north pole to complete the loop. This is how it is done. In the electric dipole, if you see this electric dipole, these lines begin from the positive charge. They start from the positive charge and end on the negative charge, or it may escape to infinity. Rather, it will start like this, end here, or it will go to infinity. So it is possible, or you can say it is impossible, to have a static arrangement of electric charges whose electric field lines they form closed loop. It is not possible. This is a very typical property of static electric field. And the tangent to magnetic field line at a point through which it is passing, this indicates the direction of magnetic field B at that point. So you can take any, say, like this tangent. This will show you the direction of magnetic field. For instance, a compass needle may be used to trace out the magnetic field lines of a bar magnet just by putting it in at different positions surrounding the bar magnet. So there is one more thing. The magnitude of a magnetic field in the region surrounding a magnet can be represented by number of magnetic lines which is passing through a unit area in that region. So here, if you see this, we have one more figure. If you see this B, and I'll show you one more figure, A and B we saw, the magnetic field, the magnitude of magnetic field B is larger than the first to the second region. There are different regions here. So here you see it's quite more. It's more. And here it's somewhat less. So the magnetic field line, they do not intersect with each other, because if they are intersecting, that means at the same point there are two directions of the magnetic field, and that is impossible. So if the magnetic field lines intersect at point P, the magnet, it should give you two directions of B, which is not possible. That is why the magnetic field or magnetic lines, field lines, they do not intersect.